Now playing BioShock Infinite.
Hey everybody, it's Azel Sparta here. Just a kind of a quick disclaimer. Unfortunately, during a recording session, a recording during the ending portion of this gameplay got corrupted and had to re-go through it again and kind of give my post-game thoughts on things. I do apologize for anyone that was watching the series in full and wanted kind of my own general kind of smooth run through things, but unfortunately, Streamlabs OBS was being Streamlabs OBS. Anyway, I do thank you for taking the time to watch the series, and I do hope you'll watch till the end. That being said, thank you and stay safe. Hey, I'm back. Yeah, like, I think what she meant by that is that, like, she looked into as many versions as she could, and there's only, like, I'm the select one that, he's like, alright, at every point where he goes and tries to save her, from this point on, he will get stopped by Songbird. So let me grab him before a certain moment, and let me try. I gotta be very precise.
Before she... There's still time.
Yeah, you have to, like, it was like, I need to grab you at this exact moment. And I only have enough for two jumps. Oh, crap. Okay, let's go grab her.
You two men upstairs. If she gets ornery, just hit her with the machines. She opens one tear and...
Comstock! What are you doing to her?
Hey, buddy. I'm back. All right then, you and me, buddy.
I gotta get in there. Maybe if I shut down those machines from upstairs.
I'm back. No more stealth. No more garbage. This red ore is really hard to see the reticle though. They just twirl.
She is not your daughter.
Thank you, and stupid collision. Hey, yeah, don't worry. I am long ammo. Yeah, I wasn't having any of that. Crap. Come on, someone has to have something. Yeah, let's double down on this combo. Oh wait, return to sender. Duh. Let me read how this works. Is it the shield that grabs all the stuff? Has the ability to absorb and collect incoming ammo. Didn't work as I wanted it to, but meh. I guess it has to be the ammo type that I have. I was supposed to deactivate something up here. I was not even paying attention. And I need vigor. Oh, yeah, I need to grab her for this lockpick. Hey, buddy. Oh, don't worry, I'm not gonna kill ya. She's gonna do that for me.
He shut down one of the generators. If we don't sedate her and he shuts down the other one, we're not sedating her.
You just have to sedate her. But you know, Comstock stingy. Oh, I see it. I see another infusion.
I spotted him.
Did you? Oh, crap. Where? Crap, I'm wasting these shots.
The Lord judges. I act.
Oh, this is not a good sign. Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
He's gone. Lay down.
Oh, there's time for everything. This is going nowhere. Holy crap, they have so much health. Finally, something. I'll finish this off if I have to. Come on. Come on. Finally. Okay. That was a trial and a half. I miss having Elizabeth giving me ammo. I need her. Why is it still just constant RPG ammo? I might have to kill that scientist. Hey, buddy. Oh, no, it's fine. Your cowering in fear means nothing to me. Why is there a tear? Oh, boy. Oh, yeah. You guys messed up. You guys messed up bad. Oh, crap. Let's go grab her.
Elizabeth, I'll be right there!
That is, I see she is pissed. Rightfully so. I mean, you know, a nice change of pace. Something tells me that she and Costa can have a nice conversation after this. Oh, which way? There we go. No? Oh, duh. Probably should look through that more. Oh, there's your jacket. Hey, how's it going? How you doing?
I got you, it's okay. Okay, I'm gonna fix this. You ready?
Just do it.
Oh, God. Straight into the spine.
Help me with this.
Understood. Why is there an X prompt just to do so? That's kind of a useless prompt.
Read it.
You dream of New York. Happens. Me, I'm the one who.
She's fortunately a way to get past Songbird. We're gonna find an airship and we'll leave
Booker.
Paris, Elizabeth. Remember, you wanted to go.
We're
to...
not leaving. We are going to find Comstock.
Uh-oh.
You saw what he turns me into. I will not allow that.
And so what? You're going to kill him?
This is where you start moralizing, Booker.
She has a point.
You forget. I know you.
I'm not going to let you kill him.
Really? Booker? What are you going to do to stop me?
Not a damn thing. Because I'm gonna do it for you.
I don't want to fight that. Alright, let's go grab that infusion and we'll be on our way.
And how to find the Prophet.
Comstock's Zeppelin is outside. The hand of the Prophet calls it.
Did you learn that?
I've been here for a while.
How long?
Long enough.
She might have been here for the full 6 months.
Need some help with this.
On it. I hope Com Comstock got what he wanted from me. Because he is not going to have long to use it. Ready.
She might have been here for that full 6 months based on how the tears were going. What's this say? Oh. This looks
important. The procedure should help immensely with the issues we've had with the girl. Once the device is implanted, any effort on her part to alter the state of things will emit a most painful electric shock. Pavlov made a dog salivate. We'll make this one weep.
Oh, so she used her powers. She dies, essentially, what is categorized as. Yeah, you use your powers, you're gonna die.
Need a lock picked.
Oh, this won't take long at all.
Okay, if we're assaulting an airship, I don't think I have the ammunition to do a full throttle on this. Yeah, that's interesting though. Like, hey, you use your powers, we're gonna shock you to basically death.
Everything here is a cipher that I understand, except for this symbol. It's a cage. Did she say anything about this?
No.
Did Lutessa just give us that thing in the cage to help her out, actually? Yeah, like, that's, Alright. Search around, see what we can find here. Yes, path straight ahead, so before that. Yeah, there's nothing else. A lot of upgrades, though, that I'm never gonna use, but I like that it's there. Nice
Look,
variety.
It's the hand of the prophet.
Comstock's
flagship.
Those are some god rays.
Find a way on board.
Stay here. I'll handle this.
We're doing this together, or I'm doing it alone.
Yeah,
either
I don't.
Way, I need to know the thing's been done.
DeWitt, you struggle against prophecy.
Oh, I love that
like
voiceover, though.
Loosed from a sling. How thrilling to launch. How breathtaking the apex. And how terrifying the descent. As gravity drags you down into the inevitable.
Like, I'm gonna see if it's possible to create, like, that kind of voiceover thing. That or if it's already been done, because that is a nice, like, eerie slash, like, dominant voiceover pick. Alright, let's look around, see.
Got it.
What's this direction, anything? I guess carbine ammo, need that. Alright, his flagship's gonna be in that direction, so.
What's that sound?
Look! Take cover!
Oh, Patriot pods.
Those aren't duds. They're.
Oh, mother.
Look around you, Elizabeth.
I
built.
Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you.
You are my heir and my blood. And what has DeWitt ever done for you? To him, you are now what you owe. His word.
He's got a blood cannon.
Means to an end.
Come on, take over him. Because I just realized I should be using this aim down size with the added bonus. Alright, let's set some traps. Chuck it again.
Thanks.
You.
That was now.
On it.
Out of ammo. Okay, that should help out for a second. Gotta find some ammo though.
There.
Open up. Patriot should have, yeah, that was an RPG round. Nice drop pods, though. Can I line this up? There we go. Do what you can. You. And done.
This ship is set to return to the hand of the prophet.
Okay.
I'm awaiting your order to proceed.
I saw a locked door in the front entrance, so we'll check on that. Probably have to use that to shoot some guys down in order to get to the top of the prophet hand, so that's going to be hopefully not too difficult of a time. I do have Undertow, though.
Need some help with this.
Really? That little old lock.
That should help me out. Heater ammo. A lot more lockpicks. Quartz, barely anything on it. There we go. Oh, Lutess. Ooh.
My brother has presented me with an ultimatum. If we do not send the girl back from where we brought her, he and I must part. Where he sees an empty page, I see King Lear. But he is my brother. So I shall play my part, knowing it shall all end in tears.
They're trying to reset everything and try to get her back to, I guess, original dimension to a degree, or at least out of here. They always have? I wonder what enemy type that is. I don't remember seeing that. They're gonna do just shoot them straight in the face every single time I see them. This interesting dynamic, though, as to, the ultimatum choice. Do you keep your counterpart brother that you kind of spent and kind of learned over? But even he's like, things are getting too out of hand. We need to find a way to fix this. Ditto aid. Yeah, I'm going to be using this on that. I know I'll be fighting on that thing, so let's use some undertow, hopefully. I might not even have to touch it. Depending on how things go, because that gear, I've never seen that before, and that is a good gear. Alright. Let's get going. It's time to enjoy some nice, smooth, solid, yeah, let's see. What is this even looking towards? There is absolutely nothing to see with that. Alright. Let's save those salts. Alright, let's get moving. There a robot in there, I wonder? Or no? Yeah. All right.
Do you think it's possible to redeem the kind of things that we've done?
Redeem? I don't see much use in that.
Yeah.
Are you afraid of God?
No. But I'm afraid of you.
I feel like that line should have gone somewhere. Oh, crap. From where? Oh, I see it.
Over there! It's Comstock's men, they're coming out to meet us.
Oh, wait, yeah. Come on. Just pretty sure I can just hook on hook. Oh, that distance is way better. Bye. all I'm trying to take. There we go, finally. Anything on your dumb barge? Nope, okay. Hold on. Oh crap, mosquitoes. Here's the other one. Actually, don't need to do that.
Over. Another gunship on the left.
I see it. Okay. Ah, two of them. Oh, I could hit him from here. Oh, yeah, it's the box. Oh, great. Now we got that enemy type going around again. Thought I had seen the last of them. They're really going at it. I can't jump over there, so I don't know what they expect me to do. Okay, it's still going. Is it? Yeah, no, they're fading off into the distance.
Look out! More of them! Watch out, rockets!
Where? Oh no! More of them. Whatever will I do? Oh, Undertow. Never change. Crap.
Watch out on the right.
Those things are actually actively annoying to me.
Booker, ammo. Catch, Booker.
Thank you. Oh, see you later. Alright, this is boring the ship.
Let's land below and fight our way up to him.
Or we can just fly this thing to Paris.
Just drop me off if you want to.
I don't know if this thing has enough fuel for Paris. Again, we do have the shock jockey.
You wouldn't, would you?
Not anymore.
Look, there's skylines all over the...
Oh, let me stop this for a second. Yeah, when you leave your headphones at a certain part of your ear and don't realize it, the moment you go to take it off a second to adjust, it really starts to ache. Okay,
surface
now
of the
where
flagship.
We go.
They're covered with those motorized Patriot pods.
Well, that must be where they're deployed from. I wouldn't go near those lines while those pods are in place.
Yeah, I'm gonna deal
top
with
the ship. Let's head
there,
up.
That one.
There.
Let's open this up now and
okay,
save us some time.
Just can't put your finger on. Soon you'll understand the man I am and the man he isn't.
That works. He traps all over the place. Yeah, this is a whole, like, battleship. Glad you will. Excuse me, sorry about that. Someone go through here? It's actually confusing a little bit. Oh. Yeah, I don't think Undertow's gonna be all over the place on this one. That works. Yeah, let's use this power boost on this stupid thing. Let's shoot behind me. Oh, crap.
Booker, the skylines lead up to the next deck. those pods, we could use them to gain access to the upper decks.
Great. Is there anything hidden? Because I need to actually use this time to get as much ammo and resources as I can. Oh, it's up here. I don't think you can go up here. Yeah.
There's no way up from here.
Looks like the only way we're reaching Comstock is over the skylines.
Those drop pod ideas are really smart, though. Look at those motorized patriots. More effective than a handyman giving them machine guns, though. Can you just drop these, or are they gonna move?
This should clear them.
Never mind, you're dropping them.
Seeds of fire that will prepare the Sodom below for the coming of the Lord. But it will not be I who carries that banner of the Lord. That job falls to you, Elizabeth.
Because he's the Lutessa's Terrors as like probability identifiers.
Skylight is clear.
Follow me.
On one side of our land stands the false shepherd, and the other, the remnants
Elizabeth.
Of the heretical Vox Populus. Which one of you men will not gladly go to his reward to see her safely to her destiny?
Rejoice!
Death has no sting.
Here, ammo.
he's really hitting those high notes now.
Get those pods off the lines.
All right, let's look around first. All right, here we go.
Fancy putting those lock picking skills to work.
On it.
You know, he's really going all at it now. He's kind of reaching this endpoint slash we're getting closer now. This is interesting. Like, I see, this is what I expected out of the Fallout 4 Predwin. Like, this level of just full-on interested. Oh, what's she have to say?
Our contraption shows us the girl is the flame that shall ignite the world. My brother says we must undo what we have done. But time is more an ocean than a river. Why try to bring in a tide that will only again go out?
Yeah, they're really trying to write there. Like, I think a lot of this game, like the main gimmick of this game, is the idea of redemption. And to redeem oneself for their actions is kind of a difficult, like, the idea that is the idea of redemption actually a viable thing, or is it just an illusion that humans have created as a way to make themselves feel better? And that's kind of an interesting argument there of like, yeah, you redeem, holy crap, that's not that much actually. Disappointing. But no, like the idea that, do you believe you can actually redeem any actions you've done in the past? And the answer is, unfortunately, up to you, and then also up to society.
Can you open this, Elizabeth?
Because society says you're redeemed, then as long as you're fine with it, it's okay. But if you say you're redeemed, but society's not okay with it, then it becomes the whole, are you really redeemed? Then you start to question yourself. It's like a weird combination of ideology. All these one struck ones are garbage. Like, you rarely actually are gonna get hit, and by the time you do get hit, you're already killing them. I looked like that was it. Head upstairs. Undertale A explosive. Honestly, at this point, now grab. Oh, three. That actually is a lot. I'm going to use this to grab myself a little bit of column A and a little bit of column B. And where is carbine? And max that out. Alright, Let us get going.
The upper deck access is blocked. The only way up is the skyline.
That's a surprise.
Yeah, I mean, these skylines have been effective all this time. Oh, this is gonna take a second.
Something's wrong.
Why are they dropping so slowly?
I don't know. We have to wait it out.
Hey, oh, the box.
The pod's ejected.
That's all?
That hurt a lot more than I thought. Alright, undertow it. I mean, that works. Oh no, we're gonna leave. We're not staying here any longer than we have to. Yeah, we're not staying any longer than we have to. We need to leave. We need to actively leave. I'm not fighting those Patriots in this kind of scenario. Oh, they can't even hit me from here. Oh, one pod left. That's gonna hurt someone's eyes, and I'm sorry.
The lines are clear.
Yeah, we're getting out of here. This is a bad scenario to be in. Almost fell to my death.
All right. I may be the one that strikes you down. But you've always had a knack for self-destruction. Who's to say you won't beat me to the punch?
Let's loop around and see if there's anything around the corner. Yeah, I wasn't dealing with that in that area. And luckily their mobility is garbage as it should be. Nope, doesn't look like it. Alright, let's go kill Comstock. He has nowhere else to actively run.
One more deck. Let me take care of this on my own.
No, I'm going with you.
She experienced countless murder at this point. I think she's deserved. Oh,
Comstock is one deck up in the Prophet's cabin.
Okay, this is gonna be a full-out firefight. Even I can tell that.
Do it!
Where? Thank you.
That'll do.
Yeah, we're not dealing any more than we have to. Combine that. A little bit of this. Yeah, no, handymans are not my cup of tea. I remember trying to play this game slightly in 1999 mode, like a year or two back. Now, like, those handymen are a real piece of work. I'm doing fine.
Take that skyline to the Prophet's cabin.
Okay. Let's go kill us a prophet.
Found some money.
Don't need it.
You pure slate clean, false ship. But time will walk backwards before you find redemption. Some sins can't be forgiven.
Okay.
Yeah, redemption.
Great.
Tricky thing. Am I gonna get hit off the edge? Alright, it's weird that she went first during that. Oh.
This is my tower. What's this?
Siphon machine.
I saw this there. I
could hear specimen containment to siphon. The machine
came to life in response.
And then in my mother's grave, there was a smaller one. They were draining me. Maybe that's why I can't.
Can't what?
When I was little, I used to be able not just to open tears, but I could create new ones. To anywhere I wanted to go. But in the tower.
Here's something I left with you.
Okay. Yeah, the tower falls. We go to Battleship Bay, which he found us. Then the Sphinx. Then she kills Daisy. We head
Booker,
to the...
No, this is between me and him.
We're walking into a trap.
I need
Yeah, no, he predicted this. He got the,
Oh, come on, I don't bite.
Wow.
My, oh my, how you have grown.
Tell me, what am I?
Look at you, child, you're a mess.
Hey, let go of her.
He's not gonna kill her.
Everything I've done to keep you safe.
Safe from what?
Seed of the prophet shall sit the throne and drown in flame the mountains of man. But the archangel revealed something else. Beware, prophet. Beware the false shepherd Booker DeWitt, for he shall be as a wall between her and destiny.
Why?
Whoa, whoa, whoa. I'm not a wall.
I've sent mighty armies to stop you. I've rained fire on you from above. I did all of that to keep you from her. When all I needed was to tell her the truth.
Which was?
Ask him, child. Ask him what happened to your finger. Ask DeWitt.
Let go of me.
Ask him. Ask the false shepherd. Tell her. Tell her, false shepherd. Tell her the truth.
My hand.
Tell her.
Please
tell her
let
about
go.
Her finger.
I'm curious how far this goes. Or is she going to kill him? Nope.
She's your daughter, you son of a bitch. And you abandoned her. Was it worth it? Huh? Did you get what you wanted?
Booker.
Tell me.
Booker.
Tell me.
It is finished.
And the job is done.
Oh. You lock her up for her whole life.
Booker.
Cut off her finger and you put it on me.
Booker, stop it.
Why? I mean, this is kind of what you wanted, to be honest. Hey, how's it going in chat? I'm enjoying these last moments
you tell
of
me, what did he mean about my finger?
Infinite and talking about
it. I just assumed you were born with it. I don't know.
Your nose.
And it all comes full circle.
What? Elizabeth, I swear to you, I have no idea what he was talking about.
You too. You just can't remember it.
No.
Here it is.
I'll prove it to you.
Oh, nope, not yet. Destroy the siphon. So let me hold out my thoughts on this one.
One of your doors. You just have to open
destroy the siphon? It's the entire tower, Booker. How are we gonna do that?
I don't know. But I'll think of something on the way.
Yeah, no, I gotta wait on this. But hey, you know. Holy crap, he really overdid it. I mean, like, in the defense, when it comes to games, we're at the final boss. You kind of just wanted to just do this half of the time with them. But, man, this is a nice looking, like... And I'm seeing, like, a little bit of Predwin Fallout 4 vibe from this. Alright, yeah, let me hold out my entire, like, thoughts through this. Like, my last playthrough of this game. Because... Like, man, this looks very... Like, this reminds me of Fallout 4 very much, and it's, like, small layout design. It is very good.
Can you get this open?
And the game with, like, 19 lockpicks. Like, you get so many of them. All right.
Cage. Cage, what is that?
Here we go.
What is she trying to tell us? Cage.
Yeah, here we go. The wave final finale. Yeah, here we go.
Okay, we gotta get ready. I think they mean to board us.
You ain't gonna place your daughter on the plank.
These are some sturdy windows.
We have to sing to him.
Sing to who? Elizabeth, stop it.
C-A-G-E.
Oh. All right, you might want to. Yeah, he, it's brute strength alone, man.
Shh, it's okay.
I am so curious what the original design for this game was involving him.
I need you to protect me. Will you do it? Will you do this for me? Just this one last.
Here we go. Yeah, this is the wave mode I'm gonna enjoy. Alright, here we go. Round two of this. I hate that I have to go through this again. I did give out like a lot of like thoughts into this as I was finishing this up, and it was nice, action-packed, and to the point. But trial and error. And hopefully this will be one of the last trial and errors I've done so far. So let's finish this up, and I'll give my thoughts at the end, so not to spoil it too much for other people. Because I did kind of give my thoughts in a beforehand little review image.
Booker, over there, the box.
We need this thing to make it to Monument Island.
Here.
Yep, gotcha. It really takes a second to load. Okay. It has been a bit too long since I played this. So I'm gonna have to remember a little bit of column A and a little bit of column B, because this is where things kind of ramp itself up.
Booker, gunships.
Get ready.
Where? Actually. Not charge. Undertow. Gotta remember this is maxed out now. Alright, that's that one. That gets rid of him. And this is red hot because of the damage boost I'm getting. I shouldn't need it too much. Where is he at? He's at the bottom. Okay, I need two. One, two, three, one, two, three. I know I'm doing this again, but man, it still feels super satisfying. Deal with that. Thank you. I need to use this as much as I can now. Thank you. I need to use this as much as I can. And there's a motorized patriot somewhere. Oh no, it's just the box talking. Okay, that's great. That's great. Come on, let's keep it moving, actually. This horse should be a smooth ride, right?
Still look, Booker, he's ready.
It's good to know, Elizabeth, but right now I need to utilize as many traps as I can.
Here you go.
Thank Got you. It. All right. Oh yeah, right. Rocket launcher and hunting rifle. Alright, and those guys are barely anywhere, so I don't care. I need more vigor though. Sorry, yes, salts. For vigors. Okay, over here. This'll work. Thank you. Where, who's talking right? There's still enemies somewhere around here, but I want to lay as many traps as I can. because this will come in handy later when I'm dealing with motorized patriots. Oh, someone's on there. I hope this works. Can I get them up?
Catch, Booker.
Great.
Thank you. I can't actively see them. This is annoying. Come on. I gotta waste. Oh, that's why, because the Undertale got them on the side so they couldn't get out. That works in my favor. I mean, either way, I can't. Crap, blimps. Okay, if I can Undertale, should be able to knock most of these guys off. No, wait. Oh, no, there's still someone right there. You and me both, Elizabeth. You and me both.
There's no way out.
This is going completely different than my last playthrough. My last playthrough was going one after the other. This one's glitched and it's fun. Okay. What? All right. Shoot. I'm gonna have to kill him for at least one of the blimps. Come on. Yep, I'm already ahead of you. And let me grab. I know there's probably a motorized patriot in there. Let me just skip ahead here.
Where should I send him?
Give me a second. Before anyone gets up here. I think I might have got them before anyone actually spawn. And I thought I could jump on that. No. Oh, no. Crap, they're attacking the main area. This is bad. Can I reach it from here? Yes, I can. Oh, that's a lot. Okay.
Right there.
Yeah, you kill all of them, and I can deal with this one. Oh, he got all of them. Holy crap. Songbird, where were you during the other portion of this game? Alright, this one's going down.
Tell me where to send him.
I need to figure out who's shooting this one. I can't tell where the gunshots are coming from. I'm so confused. Oh, this is a good run. This is a good run if I've ever seen. Thank you. Alright, I feel like Undertale has glitched out every time I've used it, so. Nope, not for you. I'm getting shot from somewhere. I feel like that was supposed to be right there, but it glitched out and just came through early. Okay. I need you there. You here. Yeah, I know the target's immune, but these guys are not. They're really going all out here. What just hit me? Everything is going all over the place, and it's really hard to keep track now that it's glitching out partially. How did that miss? Oh, this is going way worse than before. I'll take you. Okay. I'm hearing a lot of screaming from a lot of different directions. It's very conflicting. The sound ratio is all over the place, come on. Alright, possession doesn't kill specials.
Okay, Cat.
Thank you. Take care of that. I'm not going up there just to kill that thing. Thank you. Yes. Ow. What is shooting me now? Come on, there's not that many of you left anymore. Now this is just a very unfortunate slaughter. You're really trying here. Give you the benefit of the doubt. Oh, kill animation. Thank you. Hey, you got me an ending achievement. I've only killed 20 people in total with that. That really does say something. Oh. Hey. Oh. Well. He did the job for me. Alright, now for the magnum opus. This segment's gonna take a sec out of me. Man, I've... Is she running up there? Yeah. Now we're gonna end this. Sorry, my enthusiasm for this has now gone completely downhill after the whole... Well, losing that portion of the recording. Because, man, that was a way better fight for time around.
Look, you can use the songbird to bring the whole damn thing down. Destroy the siphon.
And that's what you want.
It's the only way we'll find the truth. About my finger, Comstock, everything.
Well, here we go again. Constants and variables. Yeah, I think one of the nice things about this game is that, it's one of those games that have a current taste and aftertaste. And then after the aftertaste is done and everything's settled, you give it some time.
The Whistler! Elizabeth! The bird, Elizabeth!
And then you just come back and you're like, okay, my thoughts have altered a bit, but they're usually the same about it. And I'll give my thoughts on this at the very, very end.
Where is he?
But this is still like a sad...
Okay.
The end of a guardian.
It's all right. I'm here.
He really should be more pursuer type than a story transition plot device. Because I felt like Oh, yeah.
And I'm this. Sorry.
Oh, the Big Daddy's destroyed. I think that might have been the one from...
What is this place?
Before.
Elizabeth. It's a doorway.
Yeah, because this is...
This way.
What do you mean it's a doorway?
I'll follow you in
Where
a second. I'm just...
Oh, come on.
I will say this segment I enjoy a lot.
Said about your finger.
Like, if they want to hit the dimensional door scenario, this is one way to do it and can't give that satisfying callback. Because, yeah, that route's destroyed,
over
like
here.
Before. Give me a second. You know, I'm enjoying this. Because we're black. Yeah. We're back in Rapture. Is essentially her teleportation point where opportunity awaits. And that was the first area, which got destroyed, and up here was where you get your first plasmid, which was the, I don't think it was called Shot Gaki, I forgot what it was called, but hey, yeah, you know, Gatherer's Garden, it's just nice to be back here. Like, this, coming back here at the end of this game is a reminder of how drastically different each segment, like how drastically different Infinite is from Rapture. Like, by the end of it, the city's going into a wreck panic and is decayed. Well, actually not decayed, more becoming overrun. While Rapture, the moment you enter Rapture in Bioshock 1, it's already been kind of apocalypse. Everything's gone down. Now it's just like scraps and remnants of what's left. And just literally people fighting to survive. So like, it's a nice drastic tone, and even the music, you kind of feel that more chill, cryptic vibe, where a lot of Infinite's music is always chipper and cheery, but with the slight undertone of what the world's actually like underneath the music. It's a nice reminder of how contrasting everything is. Oh man, yeah. Like, this is a portion where, like, yeah, dimension travel, this is nice. I kind of feel like they should have done a Dead Space 2 with this, though. Where in Dead Space 2, spoiler if you have, like, that game's really well played it, but you go back to the Ishimura, which is the first ship that the first game takes place on.
Why? What is going on?
Elizabeth,
what do you mean
dread,
this is a doorway?
And hold on.
I'll have to show you.
I want to get this through. And you feel this constant dread going down as you're going back into this ship layer that you've been through before, waiting for something to scare you and jump scare you. And the only jump scares that happen are all mechanical. And there were, if I remember correctly, it was where jump scares were when it came to enemies. They're just like steam coming out of a pipe or a panel falling out to try to get you. And there'll be new jump scares down the road. I felt like that would have been an interesting plot point of getting teleported to Rapture midway through the game and going back through the first, partially through the first section again, and veteran players kind of getting that dread while previous players are like, what's with this contrasting area? And that's where you can kind of get in the Bioshock collection of 1 and 2 into this. But like, this story is, I want to say it aims too high for the most part, or it had so many ideas that it probably led to a lot of writer blocks. And yeah, city in the sky for city in the ocean. To be honest, I'd take the city in the sky, because the idea of just being down here and just at least I need to see some sky, because being in the constant ocean would just literally drive me more insane.
Look at that.
Oh, here
thousands
we go.
Thousands of doors opening all at once.
Yep.
My God, they're beautiful.
What, the stars?
One sec. All right, yeah. So in my opinion, the story aims too high, or there's too many different ideas that they wanted to tell. But it's one of those things where, like,
come on, it's this way. Come on.
They had a beginning. They were stumbling on how to present the middle, and then the end kind of feels like they stuffed as many things as they could in to try to wrap it up.
Are you going to open it?
It's no good.
Also, those are like breasts more than pecs.
I thought once we were here, I could fully control it. I thought...
What is that?
It's a key.
Mm-hmm.
Where did it come from?
It's always been there. I just couldn't see it.
Like, I actually feel like this game should have been from Elizabeth's perspective, because they were obviously wanting to go for a different view. And that is disturbing.
See? Not stars. They're doors.
Doors to?
To everywhere. All that's left is the choosing.
Yeah, they wanted to aim a bit too high, but I want to say it should have been from the perspective of Elizabeth. And it's obvious it's very obvious there's a different kind of game feel to it, with your limited capabilities and equipment, and how combat situations are handled more directly than giving more options strategically, and it really doesn't matter what direction you go.
Columbia Songbird. But sometimes something's different, yet the same.
Constance.
Like, I actually think this game would have been improved greatly if it was from Elizabeth's perspective, and you kind of gain the ability within, like, combat ability should be gained within, like, 30 to 50 minutes of gameplay. Because you're already in the start. You don't have...
It always starts with a lighthouse.
You don't have the ability of combat anyway. In the first portion as you're going into a Columbia, so it will still be just the same amount of slot space.
Yes, it will.
There's so many choices.
They all lead us to the same place. Where it started.
And
no one tells me where to go.
Booker. You've already been.
And it's the perspective of her gaining grasp on the world that she was technically in over time. But that's just me going to that. I'll get into that a little bit later, but this game is very beautiful, that is without a doubt, especially with this remastered version. Even at base, the game was still top notch.
Wait a minute. I know this place. I was here 20 years ago, right after Wounded Knee. I was looking for...
Come on now, time's a-wastin'.
Why were you here?
Are you ready to have your past?
Such
erased?
A creepy pastor. Are you ready to have your and I'm trying to be silent for certain segments because still want certain things to hit.
No.
Out of curiosity.
No, I don't want to.
You already did, didn't you?
Are you ready to be born again?
I'm at least trying to stay silent, but my thoughts are like still kind of post there.
Yes.
Do you want to clean
like,
the slate?
Booker is not the main character of this. Elizabeth is 100% the main character. And in its entirety, she is the main point and plot point.
Stop it!
What are you doing to it?
Get off me! Get off!
And
you didn't go through with it.
You think a dunk in the river is going to change the things I've done?
A lot of times, I feel like Booker's character is conflicting with itself.
Open one up to Paris. I want to be shut of all this.
Not until we find Comstock.
And
Comstock's dead.
No. He was here. This way.
And I don't think they do a good, like, showing of Booker's sanity, like, decreasing. And they have, like, they give viable options as to why he should be getting more and more sane as it goes. And he just, like, sprinted towards that door. Beds.
This is the man who hired me to find you.
Really?
Yes. The girl for the debt.
There should be more like telltale signs that he's slowly going. Like the nosebleed is there. The the merger of him and his rebel self merging is one. But they kind of skip over another portion as well.
What is this?
Which is what I mean
there's
like...
There's no baby.
They're trying to hit that middle portion as best as they can.
There was no baby, and if there was, I sure as hell wouldn't give it to this guy.
But that's when you are going to
you
think Shang's weapon blacksmithing shop or whatever, and you go through that line and you hit the weapons. Oh, sorry, you hit Shang being dead, and the ratifications for that barely show.
You can wait as long as you want. Eventually, you'll give him what he wants.
How do you know all this?
I can see all the doors, and what's behind all the doors. And behind one of them, I see him.
Comstock. What choice do
and the ramifications for your actions are kind of...
Mr. Comstock
not...
washes you of all your sins.
Bring us the girl and wipe away the
debt. I actually
debt.
Enjoyed the
there
scene.
No
not for
baby.
These two, but the Lucchesis
was,
in the front.
I go to Columbia to get you.
Booker.
And there's the nosebleed effect.
I remember. What I remember.
Now we've upset him.
I don't expect this next bit. Come
on. Those two are like, they're the definition of people that say, hey, watch this, and they know exactly what's coming, but they won't tell you until you get there.
Comstock's dead. We can just go on with our lives. You don't need
dead?
Him.
You mean like Chen Lin? Like Lady Comstock?
Like the reveal?
No. He is alive in a million
hit
worlds.
As hard.
It's not over because the Prophet is dead. It will only be over.
Like the payoff in the world hit as hard as Bioshock 1's twist is. And that's like, as much of a twist as it is, it's a basic kind of twist, but it's one of those things where it's obviously in your face all the time. And this one is too, but the delivery of everything in the end doesn't hit as hard as it does for me.
Hey.
Like this segment, it's interesting, but they do it from the wrong perspective.
Give her back!
Fine, are you mad?
No, you will not get caught between, come!
It is uncomfortable enough as it is!
It's going to be more uncomfortable if you don't come now!
If I get caught, it's going to be a very long time before we see each other.
You will not get caught, I promise!
You can't promise.
You know what this reminds me of?
Agent of
the Shield, Fitz and Simmons. That's the vibe I get from this. That is the exact vibe I get from both of them, or vice versa.
Give her back, you son of a bitch.
It's ready. No.
Like, imagine if this was Booker knew this over time as his nose keeps bleeding, and he's lying to you about most of this, and he's figured out this portion by like near to mid game, and it's kind of leading you on, almost like how Elizabeth found out that he wasn't taking her to France. Like, if you were to switch those perspectives, it would be much more interesting for you to have this quote unquote not the only person that ever comes to get you, a la White Knight style. And I just feel like it would hit the story a lot differently, knowing that this person that you were with the entire time.
She's gone, Booker. Anna's gone. You shared this room with your regret for almost 20 years. Until one day.
And I can't go any further with explanation until we get a little bit further here.
A redemption. A chance for us to be together.
You know, I want to get this a bit further before I keep explaining this. Will he? Like, I think this is a smart representation of how this works to a degree. Because it hits that weird point where they do a decent job bringing as much logic as they can into this alternate dimension scenarios. However, when it comes to Booker in particular, there's nothing that makes him special that should, there's nothing that makes him special that will make Dimension Crossing not have an unstable effect on him. And there are a lot of small hints and nods to the Lutesses. These two have been doing this for a while. This trial and error of getting Elizabeth out. And you can tell that from a lot of the scenarios, but more importantly, you see them helping them throughout the game. Not because, and it's not coincidence either, which is obvious, but the idea is that they have gone through multiple dimensions doing trial and errors, constants and variables of Booker going between Booker trying to save Elizabeth multiple times, and each version has a different constant and variable factors to consider. And some are successful and some are not. In this case, with this Booker in particular, it took a large amount of tries, and you can tell by the...
Are you sure?
You can at least tell at a maybe glance, by the heads and tails coin toss, where you see one has always been heads, well, none of them has been tails. And I know my thoughts are kind of going all over the place, but this is what this game kind of does the more you think about it. It kind of jambles a lot of different things together. Yeah, here we go.
You chose to walk away, but in other oceans, you didn't. You took the baptism. You were born again as a different man.
Like, this disgusts Elizabeth, all of them that are feeling towards you.
Smother him in the crib.
Smother.
Should be the other way around. As the player, you should feel disgust in Booker. But you should be given the choice, like everyone else was.
He's Booker DeWitt.
No. I'm both.
And this death of a character, it doesn't hit hard. It doesn't hit to home the more you think about it, because it just feels off-putting. If you were to switch the roles around and you were to play as Elizabeth and you were learning, like the moment you get your powers back and you kind of learn that Booker's been lying to you about this the entire time and he actively knew partway through, then it becomes the choice that you get in both BioShock 1 and 2 of a, because this game obviously is not going for a good and bad ending. It's going for a, what you choose, it doesn't really matter too much. Because in the end, someone else has made a different choice. So they could have had an ending option of kill Booker or don't kill Booker. Because either way, in one version, someone picked it. In the other version, someone picked the other option. So this game as a whole, I do like think people should play it. It's a very good looking, fun action game to play. However, when it comes to its story, it falls off dramatically exactly at the point you get teleported into the next dimension, because it's done in a very, one, lazy reason, and two, sloppy results that kind of end in you wondering, does any of this really matter too much? And that's why my feels like, the more I thought about it after I did my first review of it, and that was just kind of my thoughts after like it crashed, and I thought, all right, I need to make something, just give my thoughts out in case I'm not able to go back in a save and finish this out. I gave my thoughts on it and I re-listened to it, and I'm like, some stuff I agree with and what I said, some stuff I don't now, because the more I thought about it, more like, I don't know if that was a strong enough reason to dislike that particular thing or not. And overall, it's just, you feel the story drop off moments, and you feel where they had an idea they wanted to hit and make it stick the landing. And unfortunately, it doesn't last as long as it needs to, and it doesn't sustain the story itself. I remember when I first played the game, the moment I had like the most annoyance was Elizabeth's mother and their reasoning for that, where instead of utilizing the siphon ability to create different kinds of enemies, they prefer to use it as a plot point in the beginning first, and then you get to see what that could potentially make in the insane asylum. But even then, that's not utilized to a good degree, because it's a very weird play stealth section that's not actually stealth. If you just do the rocket launcher combo and just murder everyone there and just keep walking, that segment in the insane asylum should have been replaced with a segment of getting teleported to Rapture and using that for a story basis there that connects it to Columbia, or at least a small hint that it does first. Because I know the DLCs, based on the last time I played it, had very serious connections to the Rapture storyline. I don't know if I'll be doing those anytime soon, to be honest, because the BioShock fatigue is kind of there. But there's a lot of different methods they could have used to change the story out. And if you ever do get a chance, hop on YouTube and watch the first initial trailer for this game, because it's supposed to be significantly more open, and you could already tell there's supposed to be a very different storyline going through. When I mean very different, I mean that concept they had was significantly different, but it was obvious by the end result there were too many hurdles they had to go through in order to get that one there. And it's one of those things where the ending result is there, but I don't think it's satisfying by the end of it. I think the more you think about it, the worse it will get for it. And with the addition of the combat kind of being more straightforward and higher difficulties require a bit more duck and hide tactics, but even then it still doesn't feel that much different. And that's a lot of to do with, as well as there's a lot of there's enemy variety, but there's not enough to make you think, because there are the standard militia, there are the two, and yes, only two enemy types that use any vigors, which is kind of weird to think about since they're easy access for all, where in Rapture it was a different scenario where that stuff was like a commodity and to sustain yourself was even more of a commodity. So in this scenario they could have actually, and that's why I'm curious if the basic concept did have it, where you could have had a lot more enemy variety that will require more combat tactics that will allow you to open up your ability to place different kind of vigor traps and more weapon use. Because in the long run of things, other than I want to say Undertow, which probably would have been a bit too annoying to deal with a lot of the ledges that you're dealing with in Columbia, almost every other vigor could have been used for an enemy type straight up right there, and that would have made it a lot more interesting scenarios for you to deal with. Don't get me wrong, I do love the handyman and heavy machine gun Patriots. They're a nice aesthetic to show kind of how messed up this world actually utilizes its machinery. But it still doesn't hit as much as it, you having more enemy variety to fight. And I feel like they could have added that in here. Even if it was light, it would have been nice to know that, hey, there's this enemy type that has this kind of vigor, because it's kind of a normal commodity that people have, but because it's in the military ranking, only select people would have it there and know how to properly use it. Because that's also a thing I can think about, where it's like, yeah, you could have this, but you could probably use it for light fun. But if you don't know how to properly use it, you're not going to be able to get a constant flow of it. And then when it comes to Elizabeth's powers, this is where I believe change of perspective to Elizabeth will cause you to be a lot more interesting of a character to it, where you could start out, you don't have to start out in the tower. You can start out being raised by a Comstock and then kind of believing that this is the only world that she knows from there until she gets locked in the tower. And you as the player are not too sure why. The mystery will be there with you and Elizabeth at the same exact time. And you kind of can try to figure it out through the pieces and the logs. Or even they could have done in, I think this would have actually been a bit too overambitious if they wanted to switch it back and forth until you guys get together. But I think that would have been too ambitious to stick with the Elizabeth line of you kind of, while in the tower, you learn the different mechanics of the game. And it's one of those things where, like, you can cut back and forth to her getting better and better at doing stuff within that tower, and that's all she knows. Like, she could learn gun combat within the tower if she wanted to. As the player, that would be like, okay, interesting. But and then you will hit that exact point where she gets her first kill. And when you see in the beginning when they're about to get caught in this airship station, where you have the choice to either stab the clerk or try to get his attention, either way it will end in a gunfight and Elizabeth will run away, because she's like gratifyingly shocked to see that much murder and gunfire happen at once. You, as a player by Booker, you've already been doing this so many times that you don't really care too much from her perspective. However, if you switch it around, and I won't say that, like, that could be like the literally I don't want to say it would be the first thing, but if it was, and that was the first introduction into combat where her character kind of has to get used to accepting that combat will happen. You have to utilize your abilities if you can. Then it becomes a whole different field. And if they want to be more ambitious with it, you could upgrade her abilities the more she's able to destroy certain siphons and learn her ability to kind of function. Because when she's outside the tower, her abilities come out more. So as you progress through the game, it would bump up your vigor abilities as well, which then would make have that make more sense in the long run of things. And by the end of the game, you're going to hit that point where you start to question Booker's actions, because you started to learn more about the world that you're in, and you learn about this random guy who was quote unquote here to save you and winds up lying to you multiple times, and he's kind of learning his own part in this. By the end of the game, after you kind of get a connection with him and you, the player as Elizabeth, then the final ultimatum of, in the end, he is Comstock. He's kind of the reason everything has been happening. Will you still allow him to live knowing that he had led your life to this much torture? And then at that point, you can either, if they want to keep it open-ended, they can just end it there. If they want to give players the usual two choices, they give them the two choices. That's just my semi-thought process on it. That's the best I could probably make up of and think at the time. But either way, I still recommend you guys to give this game a try. It is fun. It is very beautiful. The combat is fun and direct. You get to really see this kind of perspective of a utopia going under instead of the rapture of utopia's already under. Try to survive it. And with that, I do want to say thank you for watching this playthrough. I know it has had a lot of hiccups, ups and downs. But luckily, this game, along with River City and River City and Vanquish, have allowed me to kind of properly get things in order when it comes to streaming, recording, audio setup, and knowing what programs I can and cannot use. So I do thank you again, and if you can, go out, support whatever content creator you can, and stay safe out there. Thanks for watching.